Okay, we're diagnosing a 2006 Nissan Marino. ABS light on. I scanned it for codes with a G scan tool, and we came up with a C1104 front left wheel speed sensor circuit. I've already diagnosed this. I got the wheel speed sensor here, and you know what I did is I just tested at the connector. It's just a 2-pin connector, and I checked the resistance of this sensor, and I found it to be open. It was an open circuit, so there was no continuity. So we ordered a new sensor, and upon removal, this is where the sensor sits into the wheel hub, and as you can see, the tip of it is broken off. This vehicle had a wheel bearing replaced recently, and whoever installed the wheel bearing did not pull this ABS sensor out first. So, just a nice tip and some information to know: if you do a wheel bearing in a Nissan Murano, or a lot of Nissans for that matter, just be sure to pull the ABS sensor out before you replace the wheel speed, or before you replace a wheel bearing. Because if you don't, it will break the end of the wheel speed sensor off. So, just be advised. Yep, but on this one, we popped in a new wheel speed sensor. I'm about to clear this C1140, and this Nissan Murano should be fixed. Let me go under the hood real quick, and I'll show you exactly where that connector is and where the sensor goes into the back of the hub. Okay, so we had a C1104 for the left front wheel speed sensor on this Nissan Murano. As you can see right there, that's the ABS connector for the left front wheel. It comes through the inner fender well. You can just unplug it there, and you can test. That's where you would test it at. You'd test it with an ohm meter. And if you find it to be open, then that would tell you that the sensor is bad. There's also a few other ways to check them, but that's the first way I always check, just to make sure, you know, it's not an open circuit, and this one was. You can see it comes down to the wheel, into the wheel hub. And like I said, on this one, the wheel hub was replaced recently, and they did take the sensor out, and it broke the tip of the sensor off. So, if I can get the camera in there, right there, you can see where that sensor sits in that steel plate. That steel plate's part of the hub. So, FYI, just be sure to remove the sensor before doing a wheel bearing, or else the sensor will break off when you take the wheel bearing out. Thanks for watching the video. If you found this helpful, please hit the thumbs up button and be sure to subscribe to my channel. Thanks, Flat Rate Mechanic.